number three seed. He's won the last 2 weeks. From Bradford, Massachusetts, Peter Flynn.
Okay, Peter comes in averaging 125, high triple 482, roll-off score 682.
And his scores over the last 2 weeks, he threw a 396 to beat Dennis Shute a couple of weeks ago. That was a very dramatic finish, Peter throwing a double strike in the final frame. And then last week, Peter with a 377 to beat Dan Laplume. So now he goes for three in a row, and he puts his now eight-match winning streak on the line here in singles competition against the newcomer to our program from Marlborough, Massachusetts, Brian Crowell.
Okay, Brian comes in averaging 125 like Peter, high single 192, high triple same as Peter, 482, but his roll-off score, top one in the roll-off at 713.
All right, the stakes for this one, we have $500 for the runner-up, for the winner, $1,000, and also the automatic qualifying spot into the springtime Tri-State Megabucks Tournament of Champions. We'll, of course, be keeping an eye on the three-string total for our winner as well to determine the seedings. Of course, we have a couple of scores already to compare it with, so we'll talk a little bit more about that later on. Bonus ball contest, $50. That'll be at the end of the hour. Lots to get to. We will start the bowling between Brian Crowell and Peter Flynn right after we roll these messages. Don't go away. Championship time. Here we are on Stars and Strikes, Park Place Lanes in Wyndham. Two bowlers left. Our number three seed, Peter Flynn, with two big wins. The first one, of course, in dramatic fashion over Dennis Shute, and then last week over Dan Laplume. And Brian Crowell making his first appearance with us here on Stars and Strikes with that number one roll-off score of 713. So we are ready to go. Hope you enjoyed your Christmas. Probably just beginning the process of relaxing and recovering from all the excitement of Christmas Day. And Peter Flynn starts us with some excitement here in the championship match with a big strike.
There you see it. Eight pin finally goes down for the strike. Peter looking for two.
Oh, my word. Merry Christmas from Peter Flynn. Wow.
That was a little quicker than the first one. If you follow the shows, last week he had a lot of marks, and he came in full a lot of times on the head pin. Now, we talked about this a number of times, how close you are of getting a nine-pin drop or a strike. This week he made a few little adjustments, and he starts off, and he's not even breaking a sweat yet. He's thrown two balls, and he's got two strikes.
Now Brian Crowell looking to try and make something out of this shot, the 4, 5, and 7.
Might have enough angle on the wood in front of the 4-7 to carry the 5. Oh, boy, there he gets it.
Nice shot. O'Brien puts a spare up in his first box on the wins.
Need a little help from the sidewall here for the 4-pin, but just what he needed. Big arm swing for Brian. Backs the ball up, breaking from left to right for the right-hander.
A little full that time, and not much break either, as he had some pins flying around, but nothing took out these four.
One of the pins shot between the 6 and 10. You'd like to have seen those two go down, but he's left with a 2-4, 6-10.
And so it'll be a 7. A 23 start, and now Peter Flynn on a double strike.
Double strike is nice. However, this is the important ball. Counts twice. And that's making it count, although the 8 is nice. The 210 is not. But with a piece of wood next to the 2, who knows?
No, almost. Still 57 through 3.
And that's with only throwing 5 balls.
That's pretty good.
It certainly is. This is what was happening last week a lot of times. This time, spread eagle minus the 7 pin, 2-4 on the left, 3-6-10 on the right. No playable wood for him. Gotta do this on his own. So two strikes, and now it'll be two opens.
Nine box. Peter has won eight matches in a row in singles competition here on the Winds. Take another look at that.
Near 10 bucks.
Yeah. Peter just works on cut shots. Doesn't matter if it's for a spare or a 10. He's always trying to make the shot. Brian Crowell now. Down by 24 after two boxes. Not quite. Five pins still there. And the 10. Next weekend, we begin a brand new series. Saturday on Stars and Strikes Doubles from Londonderry Bowling Center. And then back here next Sunday to start the new year with a new series here on Stars and Strikes as well.
Of a break there for a ball that looked pretty good going in. The 6, 8, 9, and 10. Versus the 6, 9, 10 is a triangle in the right-hand corner, which you more than likely try to play those. Oh, yes!
My, what a shot! Oh.
Very nicely done.
And I think Brian knew he had made that one. As soon as he let it go, he felt real good about the way that ball looked when it went down. Catching the 6 pin just perfectly. Big spare there. Peter Flynn right back. 7-10. Let's see what wood is left. One piece left. And it looks like it's going to be right there.
It's going to need some help off the sidewalls.
Yeah, oh, that's it.
Well, these fellas came to play. You can show that by the last two, you can see that by the last two shots. Both bowlers have made some terrific spares.
And another eight drop. Well, we'll try a different split now. How about the 6-7?
Starting to get a little closer together. We had 7-10, now we got 6-7. Two pieces of wood in front of the six. I'm sure he'll try to use both of those because they'll snap away from each other. Ooh.
Ooh.
He may have been trying to clip a little piece of that piece of wood on the left in front of the 7 pin.
I didn't think he could get through there.
That's what he wanted to do. Well, not quite. He wanted to knock the 7 down, too. 93 through 6 with just the benefit of three marks. Of course, the big ones being the two strikes starting the match off.
Brian Crowell on a spare, and now he's got a similar shot.
Same shot, opposite side. This time a piece of wood next to the, well, actually it's a triangle in the center of the lane. 5, 8, 9, 10. Gonna go at it the same way though, after the triangle, hopefully on the left-hand side. Nope,
not quite that
5.
Time. Now I wonder if he'll try and sweep that wood over. It's not a great chance of doing it, but may as well give it a try here.
That's right. Not much to lose.
Takes the one. Trails by 27 through 5, opposite an open frame here in the sixth. Brian Crowell from Marlborough, Mass. Down in the Worcester area. Almost three times in a row. Or second in a row of that exactly, but he kicked out the 10 pin this time. Brian does a lot of his bowling at the Crowell Bowl in Stowe, and yes, there is a,
that's right,
a reason for that.
His mom and dad used to own that business.
And there's a spare for their son. Brian works, by the way, at Box Mill Farm Cider Company. I wonder if he brought some samples.
It's that time of year.
Mm-hmm. Peter Flynn letting that ball get away. And again, same spot. Peter looks up to the heavens.
Some divine intervention, but he didn't get it.
Bails out with a seven. For Peter Flynn, this is his 30th appearance with us here on the Winds of New England. His record to this point, 24-5. We've already mentioned that he's won eight straight in singles competition. And he's got a nine drop here. That record of 24-5, by far the highest winning percentage among bowlers who have made that many appearances.
Between him and Steve Vadnais, we could have a whole year and a half, 2 years of shows with those two guys.
Spare it up in the eighth. Mark number four for Peter Flynn, second spare to go with two strikes, the double strike with which he started the match. And now it's back for a consultation on the bench with his son. His coach. Brian Crowell with a good-looking first ball, and look at that leave. That's on a spare,
it's
too.
Three or four boxes in a row now. He's continually leaving the five pin and then one of the corners. In this instance, both corners.
And the nine. I would say it requires a certain amount of concentration to throw a ball that good and get that result and then hang in there to knock down two single pins and get your nine box.
That time he was a little full and not much better result. This time the 6-7-10. And let's see, piece of wood in front, half in the channel, half out in front of the 6-10. Another piece of wood down the center looking at him. And he's got to play the wood in front of the 6-10 and hope something comes off that right sidewall.
Looking for the snap, and it doesn't happen.
Keeps throwing the ball the way he is, he's going to crack a big one in the second or third game. Can't believe the breaks will keep staying like that. 93 now through eight, 17 pin advantage for Peter, plus the fill and the spare.
The two guys who've already qualified for the sixth annual Tri-State Megabucks Tournament of Champions in the spring are Mark Gregory with a 370 and Joe Ashline with a 441. One of these two guys will join them at the end of this hour. That was an eight fill on a spare for Peter Flynn, increasing his lead to 25. And the 10 box, 128 with a box to come. Peter Flynn, Bradford, Mass. He and his wife, Deborah, have two sons, 11-year-old Sean and 8-year-old Craig. Peter works for Grandpa's Printing and does a lot of his bowling at Pilgrim Lanes in Haverhill, Mass.
3-6-10 right, 7-pin. Piece of wood flat out in front. Took a piece of the wood. Got the three and almost cleared out the 6-10, but he'll be open the last two.
Maybe the biggest upset of all, Dan, is that Peter has won the last 2 weeks without hitting 400, because 400 here for him has been a regular occurrence. 137 in the opener for Peter.
Well, double mark here for Brian, and he closed the gap considerably.
Boy, again. Oh,
he put his hands up saying, what's going on here?
And then it went on. Boy, if that's all you have to do, I'm going to start trying that. Right there, bad news, right? Nope.
That time, for the first time in a long time, missing the head pin with the first ball. Four horsemen left, 6-10 right. No playable wood. Remember, he's working on a strike.
Ooh, bad break there.
five seems to be the thing on strikes lately. The last few weeks, people have been filling strikes with only five.
Oh, Brian decided to go for as many as he could get, and he will have to settle for just the five. 113 and a 24-pin lead for Peter Flynn after one championship match. Candlepin Stars and Strikes. We'll be back. We have $50 in the bonus ball contest coming up at the end of the hour, and you can only win if we have your postcards, regular size postcards only, please, with your name, your full address, the number of pins that you think will drop on the bonus ball from 1 to 10. Mail them on in, Park Place Lanes, Route 28, Windham, New Hampshire, 03087. And $50 and a couple of brand new sets of bowling balls from Paramount Industries, Medway, Mass, on the line at the end of this hour. But right now, the second game underway, and Brian Crowell starts it with a half Worcester right.
At the break, I said something to Brian. I said, boy, it looks like the ball's going in there pretty well. He says, I'm not getting it out on the lane. So the ball is probably breaking on him at the last minute and fading away from the pocket. So he's not getting a good pin action. And he tries to make that adjustment, but just a five frame to start off the second game.
Second consecutive five box he's had. Well, just to show you how valuable a double strike can be. Each bowler had four marks in the first game. Peter Flynn threw a 137 with a double strike. Brian Crowell threw a 113. Peter also filled his marks pretty well. Brian, no luck there on the 10 pin. So Peter Flynn with a 24 pin lead comes up opposite two open frames. And he'll have a spare leave on the 6-10.
Too far right.
Wow.
Didn't get enough of the wood and went straight back, lit out the 10 pin, left the 6.
And the 10.
He'll gain 5 in count opposite the 5 frame, but it could have been a lot more. Pushes the lead to 29, though. Wants the 10 pin. It's not going to go. 210 left.
Peter had a lot of things happening down there on that ball, but he still ended up with a rather questionable leave.
Well, he might be thinking about snapping this wood on the left-hand tip of it, but I'd try to cut the two pin. Now he's gonna snap the wood. Just think it was too deep for him. But with that I've seen him make over the years, I'm certainly not gonna second guess him.
A couple of tens. Peter disappointed. He thought he had made that shot, I think. Brian Crowell had that ball slip off to the right a little bit. I'm going to go to the towel and think about this a bit.
Yes, right now he's totally out of sync. Try to regroup and find himself here.
Almost. Look great if it goes.
Yeah, still looking at 6 pins. Oh boy.
And out of it with an eight. Flynn is in the pocket, but has the diamond lead. The 2, 4, 5, and 8. Oh, yes. Looks like it might have been a little full, but a little full is usually okay on the diamond.
Yeah, I was going to say the same thing. The pins just exploded off that ball and cleared all those four pins away, the 2, 4, 5, 8 diamond for the spare.
And right back, strike on spare. And that will take us to a commercial break. Peter Flynn exploding for a diamond spare with a strike on top. He's got the lead. Championship week continues. Brian Crowell. Getting some encouragement from the crowd as he is trying to show off some of the form that earned him that 7-13 in the roll-off. Finished first. Going for the spare, gets it. There's a guy that was in desperate need of a break, and he finally got one.
He's not one of those bowlers, though, that just will keep plugging no matter how bad things get. He just doesn't seem to throw anything away. He's just really out of sync right now.
Well, he converts that for a spare, but he only got the 3 fill on it. 2 in a row. First time he's had 2 marks in a row. Now Peter Flynn working on a strike. That's the second time Peter's done that today. Six fill.
Peter's still leaning, body English, trying to squeeze one more out.
7 box for Peter. Well, how about that? Both bowlers have done that now.
Both bowlers seem to be out of sync right now. First it was Brian, and now it's Peter struggling a little bit. However, he still leads by 41.
9 box.
They get 40 minus this ball. So he's had some chances to really build up a huge lead, but hasn't been able to do it.
On a spare for Brian Crowell. And he gets another break. And now he'll shoot at the 7 pin.
A mark that will probably get him back mentally in the match.
There it is.
3 in a row. Now he's got to work on getting back mathematically into the match. Down 31. Still well within striking distance with a little less than a string and a half to go. Got to hurry with that one. No.
The problem Brian has had predominantly has been the first ball.
First string, he seems to be putting it in there. This game, he's missing the head pin with the first ball. See the frustration starting to build with Brian.
7 box, 85 through 8. F- $500 to the runner-up, $1,000 to the winner. Today, Peter Flynn breaking some more pins and leaving two standing, the two and four.
He wants to be on the two-pin. So stay away from splitting them because that ball will carry him off the piece of wood in between. Just like that.
Is.
Nicely done.
Mark number seven for Peter. Each bowler with seven. Eight drop again. Chance for another. Gotta watch out for that piece of wood in the channel, though.
That's right. And this piece of wood is way out in front of the 4-7. It's not flush against it.
No problem. Two more marks for Peter Flynn. Now, Brian slipped a little bit that time, but it didn't turn out too badly. He may have a shot at this, the 5-10.
You can go with the 10 pin and the wood at the same time or jump the 5 pin over. Got to be further. Oh, got a break there. Threw his hands up because he didn't think he was far enough to the right. It's just enough.
On the head pin this time on the fill. And maybe possibilities here. Five, eight, and 10. Yep. That's five spares in the last six boxes for Brian.
Well, I didn't see that. I was thinking going in the front piece of wood. Learned something there. 112 with a ball to come.
Just grazing the head pin, and this time strike on spare. His second strike in the match. And that's a 122 for Brian Crowell, a two-game total, 235. But he's probably going to end up losing more ground in this middle game, unless Peter struggles in the final two. $10. 115, one to come. And there's a strike in the 10th. Fourth strike of the match already for Peter Flynn. Remember, he started this whole thing with a double. Three and the nine go out last. Oh, yes, a double strike in the 10th. Shades of 2 weeks ago. That time it came in the last box of the third game. This time the last box of the second. And that's Peter's second double strike today.
Just enough to nudge the five pin from behind.
135 with one more ball to come.
About
a triple, a light hit, and almost leaving the 9-10. That'll be a 143 for Peter Flynn. A two-game total of 280, and he will carry a 45-pin advantage into the third and final game. We will decide the championship here on Stars and Strikes when we come back. Peter Flynn starts game three. Well, I can't help but wonder, Dan, as Peter Flynn almost throws another strike, going into that final box of the second game, if Peter had opened there, the lead would have been under 30. Instead, now with that double strike, the lead is 45. I wonder if, I can't help but thinking that Brian was
at least thinking about that, because he knows that under 30 is a little bit easier to take than 45, certainly. With one game to go, Peter's starting game three with a spare and the eight fill. No. Leaving an opening. $10.
Brian gets up trailing by 45. He's got to be thinking 150 or 150 or more to have any shot at this match. And he's got to hope Peter has a subpar game.
Remember the two scores already posted. Mark Gregory with a 370. You got to figure that that's going to be beaten by the person who wins this match. The other score is Joe Ashline's 441.
And Brian converts for a spare. Nice shot to open game three.
Played it on the inside of the two pin. You realize the angle of the wood wasn't, he wasn't going to cut that across. Played it off the sidewall and across for the six pin and made the shot. Right back in the pocket.
Boy, Brian may be finding it here all of a sudden. He had six marks in the last portion of that second game, and we'll see.
Yeah, this could take a little wind out of the sails right here, and it's just what he doesn't need. It's a good spare and a nine-pin drop, and now if things aren't bad, they're worse.
Groans from the crowd.
Nope. He's got to cap the wood, and after that, he's still a... No.
And it'll stay there. 28 each for the opening pair. Remember, next weekend, it'll be a new year, and we'll have a new series. Saturday and Sunday, Stars and Strikes doubles at noon on Saturday, and then back here on Stars and Strikes noon on Sunday from Park Place.
6-9-10 in the right-hand corner, but he still has the 7-pin to contend with. He's going to go right to 6-10, hopefully, and dance everything across from right to left.
$9 for Peter. Big hit this time. Make it a strike, I think. Yeah.
Almost a delay of game there.
That is six strikes in the match for Peter Flynn, including two doubles.
Dropped that ball almost behind the foul line.
If Peter Flynn could put some more marks together or maybe get another double strike, he could start thinking about Joe Ashline's 441. He would need a 162 to beat it. Boy, great effort by Brian there as he tried to snap that shot over for $10. We'll take a break. Peter Flynn looking for his ninth straight win in singles here on Stars and Strikes, has a 48-pin lead and will be filling a strike when we continue.
Candlepin Stars and Strikes is sponsored by Tri-State Megabucks.
Peter Flynn's got a strike working. Looking for another. It'll be the 2, 8, and 10 instead.
The 2, 8, 10 piece of wood just to the left and one just to the right, which could help him. Oh, missed the 2-pin. He's not happy with himself on that. Very seldom you see Peter miss the object pin on a spare leaf. Gotta think he might have made that one. Funny feeling he's thinking about that 441.
I think you may be right. Well, it's gonna take a huge finish now to get up to that level. He would need 97 pins in the last five boxes. Means he'd have to have at least a double strike, or at least not a double strike, but he would have to have at least a strike somewhere. There's a spare.
Would he?
In the six. Right, because if he had 19 in every box, he'd have 95.
You're right. As usual, Doug.
Brian Crowell, boy, he's had trouble zoning in on the head pin, and when he has hit it, he hasn't always had the best of luck, as in that ball.
Give himself a lot of chances of making different spare leaves, that's for sure.
Leaves the seven, not the pin you would have expected to stay up.
Ryan's got to be thinking strikes now, too. Five frames remaining.
And a spare for Brian in the sixth. Don't forget, the next time you come down here to Park Place Lanes, whether it's to watch one of our tapings or to come down and bowl yourself, you're on Route 28 in Wyndham. Be sure and stop by and say hello to Rodney Cronin and our good friend at the Willow Tree North Restaurant. The Willow Tree North, located right inside Park Place Lanes here in Wyndham. And there is that strike I was talking about. Actually, one strike wouldn't be enough, but he doesn't necessarily have to have the strikes in a row.
But he can't afford a low fill either.
Oh my, almost the spare. Now he will need the double.
Strike.
When he comes up for his final two, 114 through eight, so Peter's at 394 with two boxes to go.
If nothing else, he's gonna have a decent 400 triple. Put him into a solid second place. Tournament champion seedings. Six on the fill for Brian. 2, 4, 6, 10 left. And
still the 2, 6, and 10 remaining. And the 9. Well, for Brian Crowell, not a successful appearance in terms of wins and losses, but certainly he becomes one of many fine bowlers who have fallen at the hands of Peter Flynn here on Stars and Strikes. It's just never happened for Brian today. He did get some marks clustered together at the end of that second game, but he had a couple of three fills mixed in there, and that really hurt him. He was not able to take advantage on a possible chance to cut into the lead, and Peter Flynn has just been rolling right along. And we'll see if Peter now can threaten Joe Ashline's 441. He must have a strike here to start it. No.
4, 8, and 10, no wood.
Almost. So Joe Ashline's 441 is safe for one more series. As we now have our first three qualifiers to the Tri-State Megabucks Tournament of Champions. Peter Flynn joins Joe Ashline and Mark Gregory. Brian Crowell, of course, will still be eligible to come back and try again before the end of the season. Peter could drive his score up over 420 if he's able to convert this mark. He does. That's 414 with a ball to come. 15 marks now for Peter Flynn in the match. 8 spares, 7 strikes, 2 double strikes.
All in a day's work.
And a 7 fill for 421. 421 for Peter Flynn. He gets congratulated by Brian Crowell as Brian comes up to fire his final two. And that's the kind of a day it's been for Brian. Buddy converts that for a spare in the ninth. Feeling we will be hearing more from Mr. Crowell.
You can see the shots that he is making today, the shades of the type of bowler he is. He just didn't have it consistently as Peter did.
Well, he's had 13 marks even to this point, only 2 fewer than Peter right now.
First difference is his fills and the fact that Peter was throwing the double strikes.
Coming up after our last break, we will award the checks, talk to both bowlers, have our bonus ball contest, and wish you a happy new year here on Stars and Strikes. Peter Flynn with the victory over Brian Crowell. The final scores, you see them, 421 to 346. We'll be back in a minute.
Candlepin Stars and Strikes is sponsored in part by Rockingham Toyota Dodge Nissan, Route 97, Salem, New Hampshire.
All right, we're back here on Stars and Strikes. Doug Brown along with Dan Murphy, and I can't help but think back to 2 weeks ago when Peter Flynn came up in the final box needing a double strike in order to win that match, which he got, of course, and then went on to win the next two matches, and now I'm beginning to wonder if anybody's going to be able to beat him. That's 9 matches in a row he's won here in singles.
And the other scary thing, he won 2 matches without hitting 400, so How many times is he coming without hitting a 400? So, unfortunately, Brian was in his way.
All right, let's talk to both of our bowlers. First of all, our runner-up, a nice round of applause for Brian Crowell. We have a second-place check here for you, Brian, which isn't the one you wanted, but it is $500, so we hope you'll enjoy that with our compliments. Your first time here, we're hoping that you come back real soon. Tough guy to face. He's been pretty busy throwing a lot of big marks over the years here.
Yes, he bowled real well. He was hot. I wasn't at all. But at least now I can smile. It's over.
Well, you got a lot of marks, but it just seemed like they weren't flowing together. It seemed you just never really got in a rhythm at all.
I was dropping it, and I was out of sync.
Well, we'll be looking forward to your next appearance real soon, all right? So, congratulations. Thank you. Thanks very much, Brian. Appreciate it. And Peter Flynn now is going to try once again on our bonus ball contest. We've got $50 in the jackpot. And before Peter gets his check, we're going to make him earn it a little bit more by throwing this last ball of the day. And it'll be an 8, it appears, unless we have any late action. 8 is it.
Unfortunately, not a match, and I'm not going to be able to see that name either, but it's a fine postcard, I can tell you that, with a picture of a casino on the front. So we'll try and decipher that a little bit later and send out a consolation prize, but it was not a match. The guess was seven. So it'll go up to $60 next week to start the new year. I guess I can't. Well, there you go. All right. Again, your coach, the whole key here. Make sure you turn and face the cameras there so that we...
Sprint team. He yelled at me for not letting him talk last week, so I'll say something.
What would you like to say?
I don't know.
Okay. Well, that's enough.
I haven't really planned anything out yet, so...
Well, you need some writers then, obviously. Well, nice job, Peter.
You saved the
big score for the end, which is the way to do it, I suppose.
Yeah, very fortunate, and got a few breaks, started out quick, and that was helped a lot.
Well, again, congratulations, and we'll be seeing you in the spring in the Tournament of Champions, and I know you know what all that's about because you're the defending champion, so now you'll have a chance to come back and win it again.
Yeah, look out, Joe. Here I come.
The challenge to Joe Ashline from Peter Flynn. Thanks very much, Peter. I tell you what, I wonder if anybody's going to be able to beat the guy right now. I mean, he is just so comfortable here and is able to seemingly get the marks whenever he needs them. Whatever the situation demands, that's the score he throws.
Well, he's certainly got the ability to throw big games, and if he gets confidence along with it, that's a tough combination.
All right, again, we want to wish all of you a happy holiday season. It'll be a new year when we talk to you again next weekend. Again, Saturday at noon for Stars and Strikes doubles, Sunday at noon for Candlepin Stars and Strikes right here at Park Place Lanes. Happy New Year, everybody. For Dan Murphy and the whole Wins crew, I'm Doug Brown. Have a good week.